Hello students, today I am going to explain you about refraction through a lens. Since refraction through a prism we have seen already. First of all, I would like to explain you about lens. So lens is a transparent refracting medium which is bounded by either two spherical surfaces or one spherical and other plane surfaces. Based on this one, there are two types of lenses. One that is convex lens. This is also known as converging lens, okay, or converging lens, and other that is concave lens, okay. This convex lens is thick in middle and thin at ends, and thick in middle, convex lens. By touching, we can realize whether it is convex or not. And concave, it is thin in middle, and while thick at ends. Just see, thick at ends, but thin in middle. So this is the identification of a convex lens by physical touch. Okay. This is bulging in middle. Okay. Now see, this is also known as converging lens, since after refraction the beams are going to refracted beams are going to meet together at a point, while here they are diverging, means spreading out after refraction. Later I will explain you by ray diagram. Okay. Now some more classification. These convex lenses are of type biconvex, as this is if both surfaces, surface 1 and surface 2, these surfaces are spherical surfaces. Why spherical? Since they are part of a sphere. Both surfaces are the part of a sphere. Okay, so both surfaces are spherical, that's why this type of lens is called as biconvex, since both surfaces are convex. Okay, spherical. Now, plano-convex. If one surface is plane and other surface is convex, so biconvex. And concavo-convex. If second one is concavo and this one is convex. See, this one is convex and second surface. This one is one, this is second, this is one, this is second. If second surface is what? Plane, then it is called plano and this one is convex, since it is bulging in middle. That's why plano convex lens. This is both spherical, so and both are bulging in middle, that's why called as biconvex. Here plano convex, here concavo convex. Similarly, concave, both biconcave, since both are just shrinking here, and here convexo, concave, convexo, convexo, concave, okay. And so plano concave. So this one is biconvex, this is your biconcave, this is plano convex, this is your plano concave, this is your concavo convex, this is your convexo concave lenses. Now some different action through these lenses, through biconvex and through biconcave. Most of the time we are not naming as biconvex and biconvex and biconcave. We take name of these lenses as convex and concave lenses. Okay, some action like converging action through converging action. Why this lens is called as converging lens? Just see. This is a convex lens, and if we split it in very small pieces, just see. Just see, in very small pieces. So, it is looking like that it is made up of so many different small prism. Here it is like a prism, this is also like a prism, and here this is like a prism, which base is here. So as by the prism we have seen the reflection through a prism. In the reflection through a prism, the light ray after refraction just trying to bend towards the base, since it is base. And a reflected ray is bending towards base. That's why when the light ray is incidenting here somewhere, it will try to bend towards base. Just see. It will try to bend towards base. Here like this. Similarly, here if a light ray will come like this, it will bend towards this one. Okay? Towards this one. That's why its nature is converging nature. Now here a concave. See, here also it is looking like a prism, but its base is in outward direction. Outside its base is in outward direction. That's why when the light ray will come from along this, it will bend towards base, so it is going along this direction. And hence it is called as a diverging lens. Okay. Now some important terms or terminology like center of curvature. Center of curvature, radius of curvature, radius of curvature, center of curvature, radius of curvature, principal axis, principal axis, optical center, and principal focus or foci, principal focus. Okay, so one by one I am going to explain you about center of curvature. As we know that, suppose this is a convex lens. See, it is quite obvious that both surfaces are spherical surfaces. Why spherical? Since they are the part of a sphere. So, see, and this one, it is also the part of a sphere. Now see, so this sphere should have, there will definitely be a center somewhere here. And it's there will be a center of this sphere also. So this let C1 for first surface, the center for the second surface, this is center. Okay, so these are center of curvatures, means center of the sphere which part is these surfaces are the part of the surface, the center of that part of a sphere, the center of those spheres is known as center of curvature, center of curvature. Now radius of curvature, see, first of all principal axis, so joining this center of curvature, both center of curvature, a line joining both center of curvature is said to be principal axis. Okay, and where the principal axis cut these points, these all are optical points and are poles, you can call it as poles. And here this one, generally if the lens is very thin, then and we don't consider any thickness, suppose thickness is very 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 less, it means if we can consider the thickness of this lens is very small or negligible one, then we measure from the center, otherwise we measure every distance from its pole. Okay, so this is your optical center, this optical center. Okay, now the distance from pole to the center is called as radius of curvature. So if your lens is very thin, then the distance from its center and from pole are not too much different, that's why we can measure from here or from here. This way, just see, for this surface center of curvature is this one, and this distance is called as radius of curvature. Okay, for this surface, this distance is called radius of curvature. So quite obvious that radius of curvature is the radius of the sphere from which this surface is made or taken. And principal axis, it is quite simple, the line joining both center of curvature is called as principal axis. Optical center, optical center is the point on the principal axis through which if a light ray comes, it emerges out. Here I will tell you, some refraction will occur. So there will be a normal drawn at this point. If a light is incidenting along this direction, just focusing along this center of curvature, means focusing along this center, this point, so it will bend towards normal, and here at this point it will move away, that's why it will become parallel to the this. So optical center is the point on the principal axis through which or towards which if a light ray is incidenting on the lens, it emerge out parallel to the incidenting one. Okay, so this point is called as optical center O. This point is called as optical center. Now principal foci or focus. Now see, plural of focus is foci. So see, there are two focus, that's why known as foci, F2, F1. One for this surface, one for this surface two. Now what is first focus and what is second focus? Just see, sorry, this one is first and this one is second. Which one is called as first focus? Just see, since there are two focus. So focus is the point on the principal axis from which all incidenting ray on the lens becomes parallel to the principal axis after refraction. after refraction. In the case of convex lens, see, this one is your first focus. And in the case of your concave, see, one in this situation I have shown you that one situation is that from the point from where the incident rays after refraction becoming parallel, and here the rays coming parallel on incidenting on the lens, and after refraction they are either diverging or converging, and here they are seen to be meeting or actually meeting. So there are two different situations. So this first situation, from where all incidenting beams after refraction becoming parallel, is called as first focus. And here the rays coming parallel, incidenting rays are parallel, and after refraction the point where they are either appearing to meet or actually meeting are known as second focus. So here this is second focus. So what is second focus in this situation? Just see. The rays coming parallel, they will near center, they are converging to this point. So this point is your second focus. Okay, this is your optical center and all of us. This is your principal axis. So this is your second focus. In the case of convex lens, since second focus lies right to this optical center, all distances will be measured from optical center in here. Otherwise, basically all distances are measured from poles. So here this is your focus, and length from optical center to this focus is called as focal length, and this focal length is positive since all distances right side to this optical center is what? Positive. That's why focal length of convex lens is positive, and here the focal length of concave lens is negative. Okay, in this situation, here first focus in the convex lens is left side, second focus right side, and this one is positive. Basically focal length is the for second focus. Okay, so what will be first focus for this concave? First focus for concave will be like this. The light rays suppose are coming like this, and after refraction if they are going to become parallel, then they are just appearing that they are coming from this point. So this is your first focus. Okay, here direction should be the direction of arrow should be there. So this is your first focus, right? So two things are quite obvious for the formation of images in next exercise. One thing, in all situation, either in convex or in concave, in both of the lenses some common points are: one, all lines incidenting parallel to the principal axis will either meet to a point or appear to be meeting at a point, means that is focus. Means all lines incidenting parallel to the principal axis, in the case of convex lens, they will pass through the focus. Very simple. And it's vice versa. Vice versa means all points coming from the focus after refraction become parallel to the principal axis. So these all are very important rules for the formation of images. Here also in this situation, all lines coming parallel, they are, if actually not meeting, then they will appear to meet at a point in the case of concave. This is your focus. Okay? And in this situation, here, they are appearing to come from this point, so after refraction they will become parallel. So these are our common rules. Now one more thing, principal plane or focal plane. So what are the planes? Focal plane, the plane which is perpendicular to the principal axis passing through the focus is called as focal plane. A plane perpendicular to the principal axis passing through the focus. Just like if this is the focus, then there will be a plane like this. There will be a plane like this. And this plane is, see, if this is a principal axis and this is a plane, so a plane perpendicular to this principal axis and passing through the focus. If this point is focus, passing through this, so this plane is called as focal plane. I think it is quite obvious. So all lines incidenting parallel to each other but not parallel to principal axis, they will meet together at some point in the principal focal plane. By diagram we can come to know, suppose there is a convex lens like this. See, all lines coming together parallel to each other, see, but they are parallel to each other but not parallel to principal axis, then what will happen? Where will they will meet? They will not meet at the focus. They will not meet at the focus, but there will be a plane. There will be a plane parallel to, okay, there will be a plane perpendicular to this principal axis and passing through this focus. So these all lines will meet together at any point in this plane. So just see, suppose okay, so they are meeting together here. Okay, so my dear students, these rules keep in mind. In next lecture I will explain you about the formation of images by using these rules. Placed in different position the object in front of a convex lens or a concave lenses. Thank you so much.